Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss polynomial functions of higher degree, and we're going to sketch the graph of f of x equals negative x to the fourth plus x squared. Let's carefully work through this example solution. The first thing we usually do when graphing polynomial functions is to find something called the end behavior. And the end behavior basically tells you how the function behaves at the far left and far right of the graph. So does it rise, does it fall, etc. So to determine the end behavior, we look at two things. The first thing we look at is the degree. In this case, the degree of the polynomial is 4. The degree is the biggest exponent we have. So we have a polynomial that has even degree. And then we look at something called the leading coefficient. The leading coefficient. The leading coefficient is the number in front of the term of highest degree. In this case, there's a negative 1 here. So the leading coefficient is negative in this case. We have a polynomial that has even degree and a negative leading coefficient. Whenever that happens, your polynomial is going to fall left, the graph falls left, and falls right. Many people memorize this. They memorize whenever you have an even degree and a negative leading coefficient, it falls left and falls right. I do not memorize it. Let me show you how I think about this because perhaps it's a little bit different and it might be helpful. So we know that we have an even degree and a negative leading coefficient. So what I do is I think about what is the simplest function I know that has these characteristics? Well, negative x squared. It has an even degree because it has a degree of 2 and it has a negative leading coefficient. And that's just an upside down u. And so it falls left and falls right. Boom, there's the answer. Whenever you're doing these end behavior problems, if you don't want to have to memorize everything, just write down what you know. For example, in this case, even degree, negative leading coefficient, and then just think about the simplest function you know that has those characteristics, and the end behavior of that function will be the same as the end behavior of the problem you're trying to do. All right, now that we've got the end behavior down, let's find the intercepts. The y-intercept is pretty easy to find. It's just going to be 0, but I'll write it down. The y-intercept. Find the y-intercept, you just always plug in 0 for x. You get f of 0, which is equal to negative 0 to the fourth, plus 0 squared, which is just 0. So when x is 0, y is 0, we get 0, 0. That's the y-intercept. Interesting part comes when we try to find the x-intercepts. Let's go ahead and do that. So to find the x-intercepts, we take our entire function and we set it equal to 0. So we take negative x to the fourth plus x squared, and we set it equal to 0. And now we have to solve for x. So you notice that it has a common factor of x squared, but we can do even better. We can pull out a negative x squared to get rid of this annoying negative that's in front of the x to the fourth. So watch this. You write down negative x squared, you put your parentheses, and then you figure out what goes here. You say, hey, what do I multiply by negative x squared in order to get negative x to the fourth? Well, x squared. Because when you multiply these, you add the exponents, and 2 plus 2 is 4. And then you say, hey, what do I multiply by negative x squared to get a positive x squared? Well, negative 1. And you can check. Negative x squared times negative 1 is positive x squared. But this factors further, and it's really important that you factor fully when you're doing this type of problem. So this is minus x squared. And this is a really easy factorization. This is just the difference of squares. So it's x minus 1, x plus 1, and it's equal to 0. And it's pretty easy to see what the answers are here, right? You're going to get 0, 1, and negative 1. So I'm going to switch colors. I'm going to go to blue because this is important. So this first factor is going to give us an answer of 0. Okay, it's going to give us x equals 0. And the number here, the 2, it's called the multiplicity, okay? So that's the 2 is the multiplicity. So it has multiplicity 2 because there's a 2 there, okay? And because it's even, I'll just put even multiplicity, right? That tells us that it's going to touch the x-axis and turn around at that number. So if you have an even multiplicity, it touches and turns around. So it touches and turns around. That's key. That's super important. That's why it's important to factor, because you might miss the multiplicities. For example, here, the multiplicity is 1. And the answer we get is 1. This has an odd multiplicity. And when that happens, it crosses the x-axis. So it crosses. And over here, it touches and turns around. And the last one, last answer we get is negative 1. And that also has an odd multiplicity, right? Because 1 is odd, and so it also crosses the x-axis. Very nice. All right, now we're ready to draw a graph. Let's do it. So here's the y-axis, and then here's the x-axis. We have x, y, and we can plot our zeros. We've got our x-intercepts. We've got 0, negative 1, and 1. So here's negative 1. Here's 1, and here's 0. So this is, I'll put tick marks, so it's pretty clear that that's negative 1 and 1. And we know it falls left and falls right, so that means it must look something like this. So at negative 1, it crosses. At 0, it touches and turns around. And then at 1, it crosses. Boom, beautiful. And that would be the graph, and this is 1, and this is negative 1. Really nice problems because they involve a lot of mathematics, and you get to use a lot of really cool stuff. So hopefully you've learned some math in this video. If you have, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg.